Big moment, big time in his career. Jason Brown, Instagram picture along with Nathan Chen. This is how long they go back. I mean, very young. They've been through thick and thin, the journey up to this level. And now on the world stage at the World Figure Skating Championships. Brown, the champion, U.S. champ back in 2015, bronze medalist this time around. He had injuries which took him away, wore a boot in Kansas City during nationals. Right now he's in eighth.
And he's in eighth with a clean short program, no quad, but he was held up with those great scores for his component score and also the grade of execution. He got a lot of positive. You can get up to a positive three or down to a negative three. And he relies on that because he doesn't have the technical difficulty.
He will be trying a quad here, though, opening with it. Definitely under-rotated, didn't get the lift that he usually does in the rest of his jumps. Very cautious attempt.
Needs to bring it back together right here. Triple axel, very nice. Triple toe. What to watch with Jason Brown is there is no skating from jump to jump, no 2 foot skating. Everything has been thought out in his choreography. He has beautiful transitions right before the jumps, very difficult ones. The spin positions, the flexibility, the one thing he's missing is the quads. He has everything else.
The degree of interest that Jason takes his step sequences, his spins to, it takes so much more energy to complete those elements than it would just a single quad toe loop. It's so difficult to hold your body and do it at such a level that your grade of execution is a plus three. That is why his skating is so appreciated by these judging panels.
And appreciated by the audience.
In this day and age where people have five quads now in a free skate, it's been actually really fun to watch Jason, who doesn't have a consistent quad, pushing the technical boundaries of the scoring system. He finds ways to get points, to add difficulty throughout his program where he doesn't have to worry about a quad.
Also to that, he's almost like the lemon sorbet in the middle of a very rich meal. He's very refreshing to watch. After you watch the men struggling with the quads and muscling through these free programs, it's very beautiful to watch him have just a very clean, beautiful moment.
Johnny, you eat at different restaurants than I, but I get your point. What a moment for him. In a whole mix of quads, you get Jason Brown, who is truly Jason Brown, unlike anybody else.
That was beautiful skating, difficult skating. The quality of his edges, the depth of his edges, I know that doesn't mean much, but you have an outside edge, you have an inside edge, you don't want to run it flat. He takes each edge and gains so much speed and leans into it. It's beautiful. So for skating nerds like us, we watch that and really appreciate it.
There are so many superlatives to his skating, and as a skater, you can appreciate the way he pushes the entire way from knee to ankle all the way to his toes. Everything is so stretched out and beautiful. But in this day and age, his technical content is that of 10 or 15 years ago. He needs to up the ante. This, he was trying with the quad toe, but very under-rotated, very cautious.
Everything else looked very clean. Here was his triple axel into a triple toe. He's very consistent, so if he got that quad, I only can imagine what his score could be.
He did land a quad this season at the Skate America, deemed under-rotated by the judging panel. But he did stand up for the first time, and that does mean something.
176.47, and the best free skate that we have seen. So say the judges, and I think the audience agrees.
He has a strategy, and it works.
Born in L.A., grew up in the Chicago area, now trains in Colorado. The 22-year-old and the U.S. champ from 2015 with 269.57. That is a satisfying performance and free skate. So the names that are next to him on the list, and we've got, remember, the top names.